in the heart of Newark. That's where I'm from. Yes, the hood, but by no means the slum. No need to change a thing about me. I'm talking Lisa Durden history. It's just me being Lisa D. It's just me being Lisa D. Y'all, it's just me being Lisa D. You see, my purpose is for me to speak and you to listen. Even if you don't agree, it's my world, renowned opinion. Lisa Durden.
Hi, and welcome to the Lisa Durden Show. As you know, I do a segment called Styling. Am I styling? You let me know. Boom. Yes, baby. Bam. Lisa's looking good, right, guys? This dress is everything. I'm sure you're wondering, why is Lisa extra dressed up and all like sparkly and red and inflamed? Because today is the show that I do once a year about hot looks for the holidays and beyond. So I try to look festive like the holidays. You like? But I'm gonna tell you right now, I am holding my stomach in, and I have on Spanx that come all the way up to the breast line. And when this segment is over, I'm going to exhale. But in the meantime, I think I'm looking good. My breasts still stand up quite nicely, right, ladies? I like it. One of the designers who made this for me, he's going to come on my show for the segment and tell you guys how to look good for the holidays and after the New Year's, so that you won't go back to the pumpkin that we are always going to when we go to the mall and shopping and the laundromat. You should still be looking kind of good. In the meantime, I can't say much about it other than it's gorgeous. Let me know what you think. Log into my website, lisadurden.com, and click on email us. It's form-fitting. It's very forgiving. Mm-hmm, booty. You know, it's stretchy, stretchy, nice. I like. In a little peekaboo. What do you think? Let me know, lisadurden.com. Now, these shoes are at, yeah, Michael did some tricks. Yes, Michael. I don't know why, but I always like Ivanka Trumps. I don't go to buy a Ivanka Trumps, I go to buy shoes. When I go to the mall, I look around and then I end up buying shoes. And then when I look around in the box, I'm like, oh, Ivanka got me again? It's something about the way Ivanka styles her shoes. I love Ivanka Trumps. Simple, they sell them at Macy's and Bloomingdale's. Go buy Ivanka Trumps and they are very, very reasonable. Her father, however, is a little crazy, but he raised some good kids. My hair, well, my hair and my face. I got my face snatched by a new makeup artist today because she's gonna come on my panel to talk about hot looks for the holidays and beyond. So she wanted to sparkle me up too with some red and some, I guess, some crimson. I like. This is some kind of new lip plumper kind of gloss that's plumping your lips. Ladies, my lips are on fire. It's like I have Listerine on my lips. I feel some kind of like tingly something. I don't know what it is, but you can tell it's plumping your lips. Although I don't need it, but it is what it is. In my hair, do I ever change my hairstyle? No. These are locks. I take the rods. I rod set them. You know, put when I wash it, put the little rods in there. Go under the dryer. I sleep in them. Then I wake up, poof, a poodle. I really desire to try some straight looks, but I don't feel like putting the wig on, like tying my locks back and putting on this thing that they said, a cap, and putting a wig on top and, you know, sweating. I don't know, but people say that I can do it. I might try it. I don't know, but right now, my normal look. If you like the look, let me know, lisadurden.com, and click on email us. Nice. Okay, I'm gonna sit down. Nice. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Ah, beautiful. Now, as you know, I do a segment called Shoutouts, where, yes, yes, that's perfect. I try to shout people out who email me, who text me, who actually go on my social media sites, and they give me a holler. I have no envelope. I normally take an envelope out and I read the emails and I tell you what they said. But I realized I was ignoring some of my friends that see me on the street. So I'm going to shout out all of my street peeps. So I have three street peeps I'm going to shout out this week. I had a good week. So the other day, I was in ShopRite in Hillside, New Jersey. I live in Newark. So Hillside's like a little city near Newark. And this lady was in line, and she said, "Lisa Durden?" I said, "Yes." So I don't know if she knew me from high school or I don't know. She said, "I watch your show. My husband watches your show. Oh, my God, I love you." I said, "Well, thank you." She said, "You look much younger in person." I'm thinking, well, damn, how old do I look on the show? I said, "Well, it's just the makeup." But I was, my feelings were not hurt, but I was just like concerned, like, what's going on? I got to moisturize or do something, some anti-aging cream. But she said, "I look younger in person." So I don't know your name, lady, but you know who you are. When you watch again, you'll know it's you. And then there are two guys I ran into independently of each other in Harlem. So I my office is in Harlem because I got to go where the coins go. People in New York loving some Lisa Durden, and I get my contracts. Clap for New York. Mm-hmm. If you can make it in New York, you can make it anywhere. New York, concrete jungle where dreams are made of. There's nothing you can't do. And stop. So I was walking to get some lunch in Harlem, East Harlem. And some guy was like, "Hey, Lisa Durden, I watch your show." And I said, "Oh, thank you." And I just kept walking. And then another guy saw me in a like one of those little, you know, places you go, like little bodegas that have like a hot and cold buffet kind of thing. I love a buffet. And he was getting his food. And he said, "Lisa Durden, I watch your show." I said, "Oh, great, thanks." He should have bought my food. Yeah, I would have really liked him. And so the second time when the second guy, one of my friends from work was like, "You better start pumping your show. People are noticing you. You should be saying, oh, and watch more and tweet it." And I just don't think to do that because, you know, you're yourself. But thank you. Those are my three shout outs. And I'm going to start pumping up my show. So if you're watching my show and you want others to watch it, go on my website. It's on the website now, lisadurden.com. And I can be found on YouTube. I've got all my episodes there. So if you don't have Cablevision, if you don't have Manhattan Neighborhood Network, or you don't have MNN.org, check me out on all my platforms. It's the bomb. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I told you that this show is an annual show called Hot Looks for the Holidays and Beyond. Let's meet our guests because it's coming up on Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, Bar Mitzvahs. I mean, there's a million and one holidays. So they're going to get you looking right and tight for the holidays, and then they're going to keep you looking good going into the new year. Let's meet our guests. This is one of my all-time favorite episodes because people are always confused as to what to do during the holidays to look good. So this is my episode that I do every season, Hot Looks for the Holiday Season and Beyond. So my first guest I'm extra excited about, not that I didn't like you all year before that and year before this and year before this, but this is my first time having a fashion designer on. That's a little different than a stylist. A clothing stylist is, or a fashion stylist is somebody that keeps up with the trends and they have clients and they want to make sure that their clients are on trend and they look good. Well, a fashion designer makes the trends. Mr. Marco Hall is a Jersey-based fashion designer, Marco. Yes. And it's so funny. I ran into Marco in New York. A lot of people are in New Jersey who are creative, but I never meet you here. I meet you in New York. Yeah. I met you at a Nightweft event.
Yes.
And you were with your client.
Yes, an attorney.
Yes, a lawyer, Eldoni. Yes. And she was looking fabulous.
Yes.
I said, I must have him on my next show. So Marco, let me just give him a little bit of your resume. It's really great. Marco has a line, we'll see it in a few minutes, but he creates fashions that are influenced by the New York nightlife, which obviously, you can see he does a good job at it, and he's you know, dressed superstars, personalities, including your muse, somebody from a French Vogue cover.
Right.
What does that mean? How did you get a French Vogue cover? Did you go to France? How does that work?
No, we shot here, actually in the States. But my friend Andre J, who's my muse, one of the photographers saw him walking down the street.
Okay.
And asked to shoot him, and it became the cover.
Really?
Yeah.
That easy?
That easy. that he's fashion. Everything about him is fashion.
Right. So when you're fashion, it's easy.
Right. Right. Everything about him is fashion. So therefore, it was easy.
Right.
It was an easy catch.
Nice. Yeah. So you do everything from obviously runway photo shoots, editorials, and I actually one of my favorite makeup artists, Tanika Green. Works with Marco a lot for his editorial shoots, and I was just getting my face snatched by her for something I was doing. And the editorial shoots are so, like, amazing. It's a little different than regular fashion. Talk a bit about, you know, when you're doing editorial, and what is editorial shoots?
Editorial is when it's promoting the look, setting the trend. Editorials is giving people something to look at, visuals is to aspire to. So it's the whole gamut from the hair, the makeup, the clothing. It could focus on the clothes, it could focus on the hair, it could focus on what the shoe, the bag, depending on what the focus is. But for me, it's all about the clothes. It's always about the clothes.
Clearly. So. And the model was standing there for a long time in the same position. Oh my God. I modeled back in the day. It's been a long time. I modeled on the Chitlin circuit back in the day, you know, right. Club Kayam. But that was a long time ago.
Very long time.
Yeah, yes. If you know Club Kayam, you just told on yourself. That's fantastic. So, you know, check out Marco. You opened up your boutique in Newark.
Yes.
So he's in Newark, so he's easy to catch. And just Google his name. He's everywhere. And we'll take a look at his 2015 fashion line from last year and talk about what's happening coming up for the fall. Now, I love Lenny Hamilton, but Lenny Hamilton, you couldn't come on my show again. I've been trying to get Lenny Hamilton on my show for years, but that's okay because Lenny Hamilton is a nice guy. He referred me to Jill Foster. Hi, Jill.
Hi.
Jill is a professional makeup artist.
Yes.
And owner of Beauty Behold Artistry, LLC.
Yes.
So you do makeup for weddings, events, photo shoots, video shoots. She did my face. Yes. Very nice. So thank you for coming.
Oh, you're welcome.
And I understand it's your first television appearance.
Yes, it is.
How do you feel, girl?
I feel great. You are making me feel absolutely comfortable being here.
Oh, good, great. Good. So we're going to talk about makeup because people make a lot of mistakes.
They sure do.
Can we talk?
They sure do.
And your face is snatched. And the thing I feel about makeup, mm-hmm. or for that matter, clothes, if you do makeup and you ain't looking cute, you can't do my makeup.
That's right. I'm my best billboard.
Talk about it.
My best billboard. I go to the grocery store. I always make my face, even if I don't do a full face, I always put on a little bit of a foundation, a powder, a little mascara, a little lip gloss, because I can't very well promote my business and be out in the grocery store, or I don't go to the laundromat, but go to the pizzeria, and someone says to me, "You're a makeup artist," and they're looking at me, you know, cross-eyed. So you always have
to,
you're your best billboard. I get a lot of work that way.
Okay.
A lot of work. People just see me and they're like, oh my God, your makeup is beautiful. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that's when I snatch out my card.
Okay. But snatch the face and snatch out the card.
Yes.
And actually, when I saw you, I'm like, oh my God, your skin is, trust me, her skin is flawless. And we were talking before, you know, I came on the show and you're like, oh, it doesn't matter if it's 4 o'clock in the morning, I wash my face. Girl, yes. This is like leather. I mean, I don't wash my face twice a day.
But we should. As women, we should. And one other thing we should always do is exfoliate. They have a lot of good products out there that has exfoliating, agents in it, where you just wash your face. See, men tend to have naturally nice skin for the most part. A lot of men.
I hate you, Marco. I hate you.
And let me tell you why. They shave. They're exfoliating.
Oh.
So you may have heard some women just put lather their faces and use a shaver just to exfoliate. There's some people who do that, but there's a lot of products out there that you can use.
And if you need to shave, because I have hair on my chinny chin chin, so I'm gonna start doing that. Yeah. I've got a mustache and I've got facial hair.
Yeah,
a sign of aging.
Yes.
But whether you have hair or not, you're saying it's good to just kind of like go up, and that helps out.
Yes. Oh, great. Yes. Great. And they have, like I said, they have washes with mild exfoliation action in it. And if you do it twice a day, and like I said, I go through my regimen, and it takes me about 15 minutes at night that I wipe my makeup off, I wash my face.
Nice.
And then I put on my products. And I'm an older woman, and I do the eye cream. And I use this great product, an emu oil.
Okay, she gave me a little gift. My mic's a little too hot. You can turn me down a little bit. She gave me a nice little gift, so I'm going to use some of that stuff when I get home, so I think I am. So we're going to get ready for Marco's clip mic, so get that ready. And after I introduce her, we'll take a look at Marco's fall collection. But in the meantime, before we watch that clip, I invited you back again, girl. Yes, Nedjetti Harvey. Now, I invited her back this year. Let me just back up a bit. What I try to do with this show every year is, it doesn't mean that I don't have people I like and I want to invite them back over and over again, but I try to expose people to different individuals so that you can get a wealth of knowledge of this makeup artist and that stylist and that designer, so that, you know, because Marco is busy. Suppose you call Marco and he's busy, but then you've seen somebody else on the Lisa Durden Show, you can call them. So I don't want to just always have the same people, but it's getting harder and harder. So I might just have my glam team come every year. I'm trying not to do that. I'm trying to give folks love, but it's busting my ass. So anyway, I invited Nedjetti back because I didn't used to do natural hair. So last year I was scrambling for a guest and I was like, oh my God, somebody canceled. So I looked around on the internet and I said, oh, natural hair, you're black, your hair's natural. You don't think of that. Hollywood is deep. They got even nappy headed girls thinking about straight hair. So I thought, okay, natural hair. So you came on and did a phenomenal job. She calls herself a celebrity hair artist. Now, why not hairstylist? What do you mean by hair artist?
You mean artiste.
Artiste.
I mean artiste. I always wondered, I coined the phrase, let me be careful with that. Artist back, like I've been in the industry 16 years. Okay. First of all, it's so great to be back.
Oh, thank you.
I love you.
Smooches.
I love you, honey. And back in the days, like in 16 years ago on the internet, everyone was like makeup artists, right. And people were calling hairstylists. And I'm like, why is that? I was like, we're artists, we're sculptors. Like, we create art, you know, one of a kind, custom made hair art. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And so I would say hair artists. So people were like, what is that? They thought it was so odd, but everyone caught on. Love it. So yes, I'm a hair artiste.
Yes.
I specialize in natural hair and locks. But I do it all, darling, you know. Yes. Hair is hair. But it's my specialty. This is how God made my hair, curly cues. And so I should be a master of self, shouldn't I?
And the weird thing is, and we'll talk about her resume, it's like phenomenal, but the weirdest thing is like natural hair. Like this week they were talking about the black model who was in Victoria's Secret fashion show, and they said it was the first black person to wear natural hair on the show. But you corrected me, honey, set me straight,
well,
tell me.
You did my research. Well, actually the first African sister, her name was Ajuma Nasiana, right? So she walked Victoria's Secret's runway in 2006.
Ah.
Yes. Okay. And she rocked her beautiful Caesar cut, looking regal and like a queen, and it was awesome. And so just recently in 2015, you see Maria Borges. She had her TWA, and that's the acronym for Teeny Weeny Afro.
Correct.
And so she looked a darling and awesome too. And so many more to follow because we need more representation.
And I read an article about she felt very uncomfortable and she tossed and turned over it, but she said, you know, let me just go for it. She didn't know how people were going to take her, so she struggled emotionally and internally. So she just went for it, and she was surprised at how many positive responses she got from that.
It's always best to be yourself. Yeah. I mean, however we came into the world, however your hair is, I don't care if it's curly, straight, it's beautiful.
And nobody white girls wear the natural hair. They didn't go. The white girls on the runway wearing natural hair,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Exactly.
Why is that a big deal?
Why is it big? Long.
Isn't that?
Exactly.
And straight. It's so great to see that. It was phenomenal. And I was just so happy. I put on my Instagram too. So.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
And I think that was the Lupita effect. Lupita Nyong'o was able to come out and wear the natural thing, so I think it gave her a little bit more
courage and bravery. Yes. Well, we all should. God did no wrong when he made our hair right.
You know, Victoria's Secret is known for long, flowy hair, so it was a pleasant change to see a natural sister and not a weave in her hair. Right. And as far as the girl with the short Caesar cut, you might say that was natural, but a Caesar cut doesn't mean natural. They want to see the hair, so that's why they say she's the first, because it was an afro as opposed to being a Caesar cut, Alec Weck.
Alec West,
with a short haircut.
She snatches it down.
But it's definitely still natural.
It's definitely natural.
But no, it's just a low cut.
Right. Right. But, you know, sorry to say, white America don't see it that way.
Exactly.
You know, so they just see a bald head as opposed to saying a natural cut.
Exactly.
So the natural hair was the afro.
Right.
The fro.
Definitely is amazing.
Somebody has to be fine. And I agree, too. Even though I'm rocking my long hair today,
I'm a natural that you purchased. As well. Yes. That I purchased. But being a makeup artist, I'm creative and I like to look different.
Yes.
At times, no, you know, yeah. I like to metamorphose into different things.
Yes.
So I, you know, put on this little cutesy dress and mm-hmm. I thought,
sexy
why not have some long walks today?
Yeah.
So.
Okay, you'll come to my salon in Bloomfield, New Jersey.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Clap your hands.
I will be there.
Yes.
We were already networking.
Yes.
Yes.
And let me tell you something. Do not be afraid of anybody on this stage.
Yes.
You New Yorkers, y'all be killing me about Jersey. When I go to New York and I'm in Harlem or Brooklyn or the Bronx or Staten Island and I tell them, oh, I'm from Newark. Oh, my God. You came all the way from Newark here? I can get to parts of New York quicker than New Yorkers by train or car. So don't be scared because they're from Jersey. They do anything, anywhere, as long as the coins are flowing. Right?
Right.
I can't stand that. They're scared
actually,
of you.
So.
You know what I mean? Don't
Queens.
Be scared. Now, I didn't want to skimp on your resume.
Oh.
So the resume is hot. Oh. And I left some stuff out last time, but I want to bring it in this time. So
right.
I was really shocked that you did the hair for Sharknado.
Oh, Sharknado 2.
Sharknado 2?
One, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
I was the key hair on Sharknado 2. It was a wonderful experience.
Oh, my God.
Experience.
And you got to do Vivica Fox?
Well, yes.
How was she? Like, how was she?
Amazing. She is so sweet. And the irony was that the day before I watched Set It Off, and so I didn't know she was going to be on set. And when I saw her the next day, yes, Miss Vivica Fox, I fanned out inside, and she did
selfie snap.
No, I mean I fanned out with saying that you know she reenacted you know my favorite part in the movie for me, and I was like, yes, Miss Vivica Fox is doing it.
Oh, nice. She seemed like she'd be like she's real, amazing. Like open. She oh you
mm-hmm.
bit.
She
yeah,
lovely.
She appears to be real nice. You work with her. Yeah.
I styled two of her hair. Her hair product for her wig line.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right, for shoots for her wig line?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Yes, so
yes.
She appears to be real welcoming.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you've done like Jada Pinkett.
Done.
You've done Uzo Aduba.
Well, I saw
Crazy Eyes.
Yes, Uzo Aduba and Daniel Brooks for the first season of Orange is the New Black.
Oh, cool.
Yes.
Twice for the red carpet.
Yes.
Looks and of course Adepero Duye.
Yes.
And
Eva
Marcel and Marsha Ambrosius and
oh, you did Marsha Ambrosius.
Yeah.
Don't you love Marsha Ambrosius?
I love her.
So music.
So sweet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Darling.
So
yes.
And don't worry about her prices, honey, because she charges the celebrity prices so she can give you the good ones.
No, I do. It's
no, don't feel afraid. Because you
no,
don't
I
you find
everybody.
The people afraid of you when you're a celebrity something.
Yeah.
Yes.
Talk about
you know,
that.
I'm very. I know that I'm a celebrity stylist, but I am a designer, first and foremost.
Right.
I design for the world. So I hate the term celebrity in front of my name, but I know
right.
with the world the way it is, that's what they like.
Right.
They want to hear the word celebrity in front of something to make you feel.
So you're
somebody in their eyes. But I'm a designer for the world.
That's right.
I design for everyone.
That's
I came in this game designing for the real people.
Right.
People who come to my store are real people.
Right.
And my
right.
boutique are real people. So I'm for the people,
yes.
but I'll take celebrity for, if it gets me to the next level,
correct.
I'll
yes.
take it. But honestly, I'm a designer for the people.
And just in case you just tuned in, he designed this dresses for me.
Mm. Yes.
You are watching the Lisa Durden Show, and this episode is called Hot Looks for the Holidays and Beyond. So just in case you don't know Marco, let's find out what he's all about with his 2015 collection. And your collection is usually inspired by, you know, prints and boldness and colors and certain kinds of materials. So let's take a look at the clip and come back and we'll talk about what you've got to do to look good because we got Thanksgiving coming up. Gobble, gobble. Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. New Year's. And 10, 9, 8, 7. I mean, and whatever else you're doing in terms of your holidays. I'm not really religious, but you know who you are. Okay, Michael, roll the clip. you just tuned in, you are watching The Lisa Durden Show, and this episode is one of my faves, Hot Looks for the Holiday Season and Beyond, because some people do not know what they're doing, and I brought my glam squad on to talk about it. So you just saw my friend Marco Hall's 2015 collection, and we introduced the panel earlier, so if you missed it, then you got to check it out online, lisadurden.com, or check me out on YouTube, and please subscribe to my page. I need to get my subscriptions up. Anyway, so let's get right into it. So to do hot looks, it's important for, you know, the hair and the makeup and the clothes to come together as one. So let's talk about this glam look that people might be looking for the holidays. We'll start with the holidays. So the glam look, and we a lot of times take our notes from, you know, Hollywood. So we'll start with you, Marco, since we just saw this. So let's start with the outfit, you know. So you are a fashion designer. So let's start with what people should be thinking about when they want to really glam up with that outfit.
Well, you know, I think for me, glam, it's a feeling. It's about your own personal style. But if you want to glam it up for the holiday, find a little sequence, something a little sparkly, i.e. right here, a little sparkly. I think a little sequence goes a long way. A beautiful cardigan with a little mohair cardigan, a little sparkly blouse, a little embellishment on your blouse or your shirt, okay. If you want to go that route. If you want to get really glammed up, a great sequence gown. Mm-hmm. It could be to knee length, it could be tee length, it could be to the floor, depending on where you're going, the gala you're going to, the event you're going to. But I definitely think a little sparkly will always add to it. But if you're a simple kind of girl, I say get a great black dress, okay, and amazing jewelry.
Ah, amazing jewelry. Like statement, yes, jewelry, right?
Statement, yes, jewelry will always bring you, yes, to that level. Yeah. You know, that great dress. That simple, like, great dress.
Yes. Right. Like what Jill has on. Right. I love her statement necklace.
Yes, right. Look, you will always see me in a necklace, earrings, bracelet, ring.
Right.
You will, mm-hmm, always see that.
But, you know, and also, yeah, some great lace. Mm-hmm. Some lace nowadays is great for the holiday. Mm-hmm. If you don't want to, you feel you don't want to be in sequins, lace is always very elegant. It has a glamour feel to it, so definitely. But of course, georgettes and chiffons are really the trend in the
Georgettes and chiffons, do you know what that is?
Yeah, sheer fabrics, layered, that's all. Look, sheer fabrics and lots of layers. Look, there you go.
No, but, you know, so sequin just never goes out of style. That's always on trend.
Well, now,
I noticed that.
Well,
like,
now it is on trend because it's not our grandmother sequins, yes, back in the day. It's not heavy.
Okay.
And then they're doing lots of textures, lots of prints, lots of different paillettes and different things with sequins. So it's looking new, looking fresh, and, you know, have beautiful details on it now. It's not that old, big, bulky sequins that we wore back in the 80s.
Child, the gown weighed more than your body.
Exactly. So now sequins is fun. That was fun. So,
and I love this. Don't we love this?
Yes.
I tried to wear this on the show. He said, no, that's for the mannequin. Okay.
But this sequence, you know, you can play with it. You touch it and it changes color. So, you know, it changes color. See, it's all gold. It's all black.
Awesome.
So it changes color.
That's beautiful.
Right. And they have beautiful prints and colors like this. So, you know, there's lots of great ones in Eric Dances and just beautiful prints of sequins nowadays. So, but definitely just a little sparkle as a holiday touch to every dress.
And it's so forgiving. Don't you think this is like any body type? Yes. So forgiving?
Yes. Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, the face.
Yes.
I got to tell you, girl, people try so hard to glam up till they have these crazy eyebrows and they have the black lip liner. What is going on with these faces during the holidays? They are, not all, but you know when you're a disaster, you're a disaster. Those selfies need to be help-me's.
I know, and the two-tone skin.
Girl, talk it with the makeup.
Yes. You know, a little bit goes a far way, but for the holiday, you might want to do like the, you know, that classy smoky eye. You might want to, the metallics are in. Marco mentioned the sequins, metallics are in, the metallic eyeshadows. Particularly if you're wearing a simple black dress, mm-hmm, you might want to glam up those eyes with some metallic, especially if you're going out. If you're going to a New Year's party, that's the way to go.
Yes. Okay.
Nice. Another thing that's in is the classic cat eye. You'll see a lot of people wearing the cat eye.
Now, how do you I tried to get it with the eyeliner, but how do you get it out there and it's not running? How do you do that?
Well,
love that look.
It depends on the instrument that you're using,
okay,
and the product that you're using. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But they have some liquid eyeliners that you can just purchase that has the actual sponge applicator that's thin that you can kind of just like stroke it on.
Oh.
But it does take practice, I'm not going to lie.
Or they can call you.
Yeah, or they can call me. Absolutely. I love it. But even with the classic cat eye, you can do little things to glam it up for the holiday. You can take like some sparkly glitter and do a line over top of the line, something to give it a little bit more pop.
Oh, nice.
You know, the bold lip is always good. But if you're going to do like a really, really heavy eye, I would suggest that you do like a really nice lip gloss.
Like the one you gave me?
Right, yeah. Yes.
The mentholiptic lip gloss, because I feel my lips are tingling.
I'm glad I warned you, because I did. I had to warn you. Yes.
It's not hurting, but I feel my lips.
Yeah.
I know that they're there.
Yeah, there's a buxom product for your lips, and it's a lip gloss, but it does plump it up, and you can feel it working when you put it on.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So I kind of gave you a little warning, because I didn't want her to say, what the heck did you put on my lips? Like,
oh, my God. No, but it's good, yeah. Now, hair, you know.
Yes, sir.
I didn't want to talk about straight hair, because we've gotten that down pat. Weaves, wigs, front.
No, I don't think we got it down pat.
Oh,
go ahead.
We're going to name some names. We're going to name some names on the red carpet. We're going to talk about that in a minute, because I'm going to red carpet right after this. So we're going to talk about who did it best and who did it worst. In terms of looks.
Right.
So natural hair, you know, so I struggle to do something different with my hair because it's natural. Like, can we do something different with natural hair for the holidays? Because we just think it's like, we're just stuck in the one look.
Do we? Well, of course not. Natural hair is versatile. So with natural hair, we know that it tends to be dry, excessively dry, because it lacks natural oils. So we always want to work and use the right products to moisturize the hair. And so I'm not sure, well, as I mentioned before, I'm a soft sheen collagen educator.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And so we have the Au Naturel line
for
natural hair. So you have the sulfate-free shampoo, the Knocked Out Conditioner, and then also one of my favorite products is the Curl Defining Cream Glaze. And what I love about it has mango oil for moisturization and bamboo milk for elongation. So it'll give you that moisture. And then also, a lot of times, like for for the holidays, a lot of times people want to do protective hairstyles. So we have, so a nice trend is the crochet hairstyle. So you braid your hair, but you have to take care of your own hair before you braid it down. You cornrow your hair, and then you take a crochet needle, and you take the nice curly hair, and then you go throughout the braids. It's amazing, and it's a nice protective hairstyle you can wear like up to 2 to 3 weeks. But it's very important to get, like when it comes to natural hair, you have to get your quarterly trims, you have to get your steam treatments and so on, and to definitely retain the integrity of the natural hair.
Yeah, because people think natural hair is super easy. It's still hair.
It's very easy because I'm a master at that.
Well, of course, it's easy for you because, you're a hair artist, but people think, you know, it must be so easy to do your, you know,
it is.
Talk about
hair
this.
Yeah, it's natural.
Why because do you have to find the right products for your hair?
I don't have the right products. I'm very lazy when it comes to hair because I have people who do my hair for me, so I just sit back. But I'm very lazy.
That's all it takes. And then there's another method, the LOC, LLC method. You heard about that? Liquid oil and cream. Mm-hmm. It's amazing. Though Naturelle has a line for that too. So natural hair.
So it's about products. So another
products.
Not just straight hair needs product.
Right.
Natural hair needs product.
Natural hair.
Now,
yes.
No, go right ahead. Yes. You take it off my show, girl. Just go right ahead. Take off my show.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just have a quick question.
No, I love it.
The moisture.
Because I wear my hair natural.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you have to wet it every day? I find that I have to wet it.
Yes, you have
To give it that moisture.
You have to give it that the liquid. That's why the lock method is amazing. You know, you have the liquid, so you want your water found base to it.
I see.
It's the liquid conditioner. Then you want to follow up with your oil.
Right.
You want that oil to penetrate those cuticles. You know, great natural products that your coconut and
that's
avocado.
That's a good point you raised.
Yeah. And then you want to follow up with a styling cream. Mm-hmm. And that's going to define your curls.
Okay, nice. Yeah.
So, yes.
Do you suggest any kind of hair jewelry?
The naturalistas do it the night before.
Night before, guys. So, night before.
Very important.
You know, for the holidays.
For the holidays.
And now, do you do any hair jewelry? Like, is that out of style? What about hair jewelry?
With my clients, not too well. With the,
I mean, I'm just asking because I've seen it before, but is that on trend or that's done?
With my salon clients, well, we're just getting into the holidays now, but pretty much not really.
Okay, hair jewelry, people. That was yesteryear.
It depends on the event. If the client is going out for an event and red carpet, and then yes, they're going to bring that. But I guess I'm talking about my salon clients because
I love them.
And right. They come and they want their hair just, they come on a regular basis, on a monthly basis, and get it taken care of.
Yeah. Now, when we're talking about dressing up for the holidays, I do want to talk a bit about who did it best and who did it worse in the celeb world on red carpets, because red carpets kind of give us the jump off point for how we want to look for our special occasions.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So let's start with who did it best and worst in the hair category.
Viola Miss Davis. Viola Davis is amazing. Don't you see how pretty natural hair, her pretty brown hue color, and she is just glowing. So I love Viola Davis, and Tiana Paris is amazing. Yeah. And of course, we talk about Lupita Nyong'o, and also, we cannot forget thought-provoking director Ava DuVernay with her luscious locks.
Oh, don't you love Ava?
Love her.
Yes.
So, yes.
Okay, so she did it best in the hair?
They all are doing it wonderful.
Natural hair, yeah.
Yeah, what'd you say?
For the all-natural hair, they do wonderful.
Now, who did it, I'm going to go with you, who did it worst for makeup? Who jacked themselves up? It could be any in the red carpet.
I don't know anybody specifically that I think that did it really bad, but I don't like that goth look. I don't like when the makeup is way too dark.
Okay.
Fortunately, I've been seeing a lot of the natural looks on the red carpet. They're not piling on the makeup, which has been really pretty. Mm-hmm. But anytime someone's wearing like a really dark lip and, you know, really dark blush, it doesn't go well on the red carpet.
Gotcha.
I don't think that you should do that on a red carpet. Mm. There's a place and time for certain looks, and that goth look is not the place for it.
Okay,
not
so if you're
looking for you, you think so it's too heavy?
It's just not for a red carpet. So if you're looking, and that's my own personal opinion.
No, we have the style experts to say, you know, what works and what doesn't work. People look for their style from that sometimes.
Right.
If they didn't see my show, they might be looking to those individuals for their look for the holidays.
Yeah.
Now, we know. We don't have my girl Joan every Friday anymore.
Right.
So you got to take her place. Who did it best and who did it worst in the fashion, in the clothing area? And these people have like a lot of money for designers. So like, how do you screw that up?
Well, one, how they screw it up. Let's go over how they screw it up. They screw it up because their stylists don't know them. That's first and foremost. Mm-hmm. And sometimes people jump on the trend with who got the hottest stylist, and I want to use them too. So there's no personal connection with them. Mm-hmm. So I put on what I think is good. Mm-hmm. And sometimes people try to incorporate their own personal style in it, and sometimes it's a miss because sometimes you don't even know your own body or you don't even know you don't even have a real look because someone's so used to putting you together. So when you try someone new, they don't know you. So therefore, now you're a product of what they think you should look like as opposed to what you know you should look like. Mm-hmm. And so you think because everyone around you in that team go, oh my God, you look amazing, you look amazing, you put it on. And then you get out there, next thing you know, you're on the worst dress list because you look a mess. Because you have to be able to carry the look. You know, it's like Rihanna, no matter what she puts on, it's a winner. She's a winner.
Yes.
She just has personal style.
She does.
And she could carry anything. She has a confidence that is unmatched on a carpet or any red carpet. So she has a style. Just like Charlize Theron. She can never go wrong.
Oh, yeah.
Every time she put on something. Even Nicole Kidman, every time she put on something, she always is a hit. Cate Blanchett. Every time she put on something, she's a hit. They just know their body, they know their style, and they carry it. Mm-hmm. They know how to carry the look.
And you know who gets it right every time? Who's Halle Berry gets it right every
time.
Can we talk? Are we wrong?
No.
Oh, okay. We listen to Marco.
No, you're not wrong. You're not wrong, but you know what?
Oh, she ain't liking it.
You know what?
Wait.
It's not that she gets it right. She gets it right, but then it becomes predictable. You know,
she doesn't try new things, they keep her
close to range of what she always looked like.
Yeah, yeah,
she
yeah.
never really steps out, and when she do step out the box, it can go. She has a great body, so it can go either way.
Right, it can go either way.
Sometimes she put on stuff, it can go either way for her. Sometimes she just looks very, it looks kind of boring, and then sometimes it's like, oh my God.
Right.
You know, it's the wild factor.
That's true.
She never, it's never like,
it's too safe.
Right.
It's always too safe.
It's either too safe or it's on the envelope of being, she just right there.
On the envelope of being, by Felicia.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, but she always, bye, Felicia. But she always gets records. They know her. You know, you yeah. know she. Yeah. You yeah. can't yeah. help but say she looks good in her clothes.
Yeah,
her
she's
clothes,
just so drop dead gorgeous.
Like, unlike Beyonce, who to me never gets it right.
Ooh.
Never gets
now
right.
me. I'm kind of shady with her. Like sometimes I'm like Beyonce girl, and then I'm like, yeah. oh Beyonce. So you tell me why you. And let's talk about Beyonce from head to toe. Cause she had some kind of crazy bang thing going on.
She has the prom syndrome. And when I say she has a prom syndrome,
don't for the holidays, don't do the prom syndrome.
Always silhouette. It's all, no, it's not her mother no more. No, it's that's, not no, her can't even count her mother no more. Her mother, no. No, it's always here. Skin tight. Skin tight. Flare out. Skin tight, flare out. That's uh-huh. all. That's what she does. Show my body, and I got a trumpet at the bottom. Girl, that's the prom syndrome. You like you going to the prom? Now you now you're dressing. Now you're dressing overtly sexy, which you shouldn't even have to go to. Girl, you already got a body, so you ain't right. got to give all that.
Right, right.
And
right.
you just and you're not even. First off, you're not fashion. And anyone who says she is, she's not fashion at ooh. All.
This is my first show going hard on Beyonce. Well, Beyonce, well. I love you, girl, but this is what... Oh, wait, you
ever seen those... I should go hard on her.
You know those disclaimers? What he says on this show is not my opinion.
I have a lot of haters. She wears nice things, but to me, she's not fashion. She's not even stylish to me at all. By far, to me. I have fights with people.
First.
I have fights with people about her and Rihanna. They saying that she dressed better than Rihanna. Absolutely not.
No, I don't agree with that either.
Absolutely not.
Now, did you see those like bang that? Remember that bang thing that you? Bang? I know you do natural hair, but did you see what the bang?
I do all hair. I specialize in natural. Okay, you know, one of my favorite clients is Adapiro Duye.
Oh, okay.
Hello.
Perfect. Okay, yes. Beyonce had this bang thing.
What
that
bang
didn't
with a side ponytail?
No. It was some kind of she did some kind of thing. She was in France and she had some kind of like raggedy bang thing on. Did you remember that bang thing? We have to move on. It was just that bad.
I don't remember.
And it was like her big forehead was short. It was like a jacked up bang wig.
It was this. Short.
Oh, when she cut the
bang.
Oh, that.
Remember that? The choppy, was it choppy bang?
Yes!
There's a bang that cut her like right here.
What happened? Yes. She's beyond, talk about that. What was that?
That's called,
what she wanted.
Listen, and that's called them trying to get, it's called them trying to make her fashionable.
Right.
And she cannot carry that. Beyonce is a plain Jane girl. They just dress her up. She's a plain Jane. She can't carry that because that's not her style. That's not her image. Beyonce is a sexy girl.
She's
it's
sexy.
About voluminous hair. Yes. It's about being volume and being sexy, right. being kitten, being Victoria's Secret. She is not that kind of girl to say, I am fashion. Solange is fashion.
Right.
Beyonce is sexy.
Solange, turn it out.
Talk about that, right? Talk about
her hair. Who never gets it wrong?
That. I just love how she just love embrace who she is. Right. I mean, we're supposed to embrace our natural hair. Right. It's so she just does who she is.
And she never gets it wrong.
And she carries it.
And
well.
She does it so beautifully. Yeah. I'm like, yes, be you, as we all should. So
now,
I love that about her.
When people, so we talked about the red carpet and these looks that we like to look at and say, can I look like Beyonce, Solange, you know? They're telling you what to do, what not to do, and why it works or doesn't work. So that means it's going to happen to you, too. Now, let's get to the regular Jane Doe and John Doe. When people are thinking about the look for the holidays, what shouldn't people, why shouldn't people wait till the last minute to think about this? Because, like, I'm giving them a week advance. Okay, go ahead.
In life and everything, preparation key, unless you like to just, like, operate on it just, like, spontaneously, like, I'm here. Everyone has different personalities, so if that's who you are, go for it. But I like to prepare. I mean, personally, if it was me, I like to
What makes it a bad idea to wait last minute and then you try something new with the hair, makeup, and clothes? We'll start with the hair, and then we'll go down the line.
And you're going to get that new look that you may not be comfortable walking the red carpet with. If you don't see what your vision is and what you visualize, if you don't see that beforehand, then that's what's going to happen. I mean, but if you're a free spirit, embrace it.
Now, makeup, if they're saying, I'm going to go to the store and buy this new makeup or something, you know, wherever they're going to buy the makeup, you know, MAC counter, because I want to have this look for the holidays, and they buy it new and try it new last minute, what can go wrong?
Everything can go wrong.
Everything does go wrong.
Everything, because there are 1,000 products out there, more than 1,000 products, and you can buy something because you watched a YouTube video, and you go and you get it, and just like with the cat eye, you can buy the instrument, and you'll have a black glob on your eye if you're not used to using it. So everything can go wrong with it. That's one reason why you should prepare. If you're not a makeup artist and you are going to be doing your own makeup, if you buy your makeup, practice with it. Don't wait until that day and you're going out, because you will find it's an art. to make up a face. You may watch a YouTube video. It's just like you can see somebody doing surgery and they make it look easy because that's their thing.
That's a school.
Mm-hmm.
But you shouldn't work. Mm-hmm. You shouldn't wait the last minute.
Yeah. Okay, Marco, in terms of clothes, why is it a disaster to wait till the last minute?
Because, one, you wait till the last minute and you buy something that you know you don't want. So you buy it because you think, I need this to put on now. So now you got something on that you didn't really want to have on. Two, it might be ill-fitted.
Yes.
And now you don't have time to go to the tailor or the or seamstress to get it altered.
Mm-hmm.
And two, it just, it's not good to rush a look, especially if you're not a stylish person. So now you're just picking out any old crap.
Exactly.
And so you don't really know how to put it together. So now you got a whole outfit you don't even know what you look like.
Right.
And you put it on you, and then you always got that one person or a few people telling you look good, and you know you really don't look good.
Oh, yeah, the liars?
Yeah.
Oh, the yes people?
Yes. The lies, the yes people. Yeah. I don't call them lies. They're the yes people. And you, so mm-hmm. yeah, it just always goes wrong last minute when you don't know when you just fall into a store and pick something up.
Now here's the thing: this will be our last thing before we get into closing the show. We got about 10 minutes left, so I want to talk about this. So we talked about all the trending looks and what happens on the runway and what happens on the red carpet and what looks good and what doesn't look good, and we can get our cues from the celebrities and we're giving regular folks some ideas from the panel. Okay, now that we have them looking good, how do they take that look from the club or however they're hanging out to the office party where you can't be as turned up, but you need to be a little festive because you have the office holiday party. So let's talk about how they can, because, you know, it can be expensive. You don't want to just, like, you know, how can you merge those two things to make sure you're looking good from the office to out or from out to the office? The office holiday party.
Again, that great little black dress, red dress, green dress, whatever holiday color dress, that gold dress, that silver dress, whichever. You get a great fitted dress that could go from day to evening, that could take you from different occasions. And it's always nice to have a great cardigan or a great blazer to go over something.
Blazer.
You know, have that great blazer, that great cardigan can go over your that dress that you might want to go from the office party to the nightclub.
Okay.
And you know, so you could take it off. A statement piece of jewelry can all go far. A great scarf. You know, anything you can go from day to evening with, from the club or the red carpet to, it's about the fit. You know, it's always nice to have a simple, easy piece. So if you got a simple, easy piece that you can dress up or dress down, accessories are key to taking you from day to evening. So if you got great accessories, a great shoe, a great bag, great necklace, great earring, you could go from day to evening. So it doesn't even matter. So.
And with makeup, how do you go from the office party, looking like you're at an office party,
mm-hmm.
and then turning it up when you're going to the club or something go festive?
Carry your little makeup purse and have additional makeup in there. And what you can do is you can layer, just like Marco talked about layering with clothes to make it easy, blazer, simple dress underneath, take it off, that sort of thing. You want to do the same thing with your makeup. Your makeup is more simple because you're in the office. Right before you leave that office and you're headed out to that party and you want to glam it up a little bit, you can layer your makeup. You can add a little more in the corners. You can put some metallic on your eyes. You can even pull out your eyelashes if you need to do that and put on some eyelashes and bold up your lips, and you're ready to go. You don't have to do a new face. Just have your little makeup clutch with you.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, it's a little harder.
Never harder when it comes to natural hair.
Oh, okay, so, talking girl, talking.
The versatility is there. Like, for instance, you see how my hair is up?
Okay.
Voila, office look, right? You go in there, you're like, yes, I'm in office look. Okay, I'm ready to go to the club. So then what you do is you take your band out. This is a scarf. And you take it out. You have your bobby pins. All you need is like 3. And then you do a faux hawk. You just put the sides back.
Ah.
And you take your hair and just push it out and pull it out like this. You're like, club, what? I'm ready.
Nice.
So yes, that's the versatility natural. And you know, I was talking about my working on my natural hair show. Hear me out.
Talk about it.
Hear me out. H-A-I-R. Hear me out with Nedjetti Harvey.
Okay.
It's coming to a network near you. So let me tell you, I'm going to teach people about natural hairstyling and the maintenance, the versatility in it. It's going to be amazing. You have to go on my website and stay tuned to keep stay abreast with it. But it's coming.
And anything excited you want to know about these wonderful individuals on the panel, go to my website. You'll have more information about them, lisadurden.com. And, you know, I'll have their bios and how to connect with them, because you're just not going to learn about this from my show. We're going to have a conversation beyond this, because you'll be able to catch up with me and, you know, catch up with them through my website. 5 minutes? Okay, we got five more minutes. I'm going to squeeze a couple of other things up in her. Okay, real quickly, you know, so we have 5 more minutes, just some real quick, you know, bullets, do's and don'ts, trying to look good for the holidays and beyond. So, like, now that we've, you know, we've done the holiday thing, how do we keep ourselves looking good beyond without looking crazy? So, when I say beyond, you know, a little bit, keep up the nice appearance that you didn't do. Mm-hmm. And so some do's and don'ts.
Great blazer, a good pair of jeans, a good skirt, a good white shirt. Can never go wrong.
Okay, what kind of skirt? Pencil skirt?
Pencil skirt. Okay. Pencil skirt, long skirt, just a good skirt. These things can take you, can keep you looking good all throughout the year. The five essentials, always the five essentials.
Nice, and they're timeless.
They're timeless pieces.
Yes. Yes. Okay, nice, some do's and don'ts.
A do, take care of your palate, take care of your skin, use products, wash your face, do it twice a day. You brush your teeth twice a day.
I don't do that either.
That's why I got gum disease. TMI. But anyway.
Well, I feel like I'm supposed to brush the teeth after every meal. I really don't do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm shady.
So that's kind of my do and my don't.
Okay.
Don't go to bed without washing your face, you know, and do wash your face and moisturize and have some sort of a facial system. And if you need to know more about it, you can
go on my website and find information about her.
Yes.
I'll have her website on my website. And then you can rock out with her. And of course, they're on all the social media platforms. So you have their names and just Google them. Yeah.
Well, the dudes with natural hair, I always say, get your quarterly trims. It maintains the integrity of your hair.
Yes.
Avoid split ends.
I never do that.
Get your monthly steam treatments. It hydrates, moisturizes your hair. It's very, very important. And another do is to, style your own natural hair without adding extensions. Try that. It's amazing.
Oh, you know, people don't do that a lot.
A lot of people don't do that, right? Give it a try. Embrace your own length, your own hair type. It doesn't matter what it is. You're beautiful. Give that a try.
Okay.
And the don't, if you're going to get color, please don't color your hair. If you have damaged hair anywhere, please.
I know.
The foundation has to be healthy.
Yeah.
So don't do that. And don't compare your own hair type with anyone else.
Right.
Embrace who you are. Yes. Yours is beautiful.
Because I colored my hair one time years ago, and I looked like Dennis Rodman on crack.
Oh, my goodness.
Child, I caught myself trying to get brown hair, and I went to a colorist.
Oh,
and they stripped the hair, and then they put the blonde, they put the brown on top, and I turned blonde, and I was looking crazy.
Yes,
but it's interesting what men like. Latino men never like me. When my hair was blonde, mommy.
Really?
Caribbean men never like me because I'm too skinny for them. And when my hair was blonde, it was a weird thing. But then it was weird. American black men could pay me no mind. That was the good news.
Really?
Because I knew it was going to grow out. So it was a whip. Blondes do have more fun. And so, but it just looked like really fried and unhealthy and burned. So like your color is gorgeous.
You like it?
What color? I would like that color. What color is that?
Well, I only endorse products. I'm on the payroll.
So. We ain't going to do that. But just what color is it? We
don't need to. It's a sunspot brown.
So I'm going to let you color my hair?
Will you? I'll do it. I just colored one of my clients this color. She loved it. She said, we colored twins. So a lot of people like it. So I would love to color your hair, doll.
And how long do we have now? 3 minutes? Okay, good. Because I want to ask you now so we have the basics and so this is just extra stuff. So now, how far out should we go when we're doing something for the new year? Like to me, that color would be so far away from my natural color. So people kind of jump over the cliff when they try something new. So to me, that would be like a little bit of a movement from my color now. So how close and how safe should we be During holidays? Are we wrapping that up? Darn. Well, you got enough on the show. You can go on my website, lisadurden.com, and you can write me. If you have any show ideas or any questions for them, write me and tell me what you want them to tell you, and I'll put it on my website. Check me out on YouTube, Facebook, tweet me. lisadurden.com, click on email us. We got to go. Bye. Thanks for coming. Don't you love the dress?
Yes.
Don't you love the
beautiful
face?
Yes.
Don't you love the hair? Don't you love the hair?
Thanks.
Don't you love my dress? Yes. Thanks, Marco.
You're welcome.
And Marco's going to be dressing me for the Revolution Awards.
Ooh, nice.
I've already decided.
He's going to be dressed.
And I'm going to get my hair colored.
Yes.
Yes.